So we now move on to the fifth sum. We move on to the fifth sum. That is here. Now, as usual, I'm going to take my left hand side. I'm going to take the left hand side. Okay. So and then we'll see. And now we all know there is a there is a relationship between tan square and what secant square. That means there is a relation between the left hand side and the right hand side. There is a relationship. Okay. We all know which formula that is. Formula number 29. Okay. So what we'll do first, we'll try to do now the first thing what comes to our mind is when you look at this. Tan raised to 4 and tan square, both are tan 10. That means what we can do, first thing is what, take common. Yes or no, take the common. So what I'll do, tan raised to 4 and tan square. Common is usually the smallest one. So between tan raised to 4 and tan raised to 2, tan 4 or tan 2, sabse chota kone tan 2, that is tan square theta. Okay, so I'll take tan square theta common. So if I take tan square theta common, what do I get? So tan raised to 4 minus tan raised to 2 becomes tan raised to 2 theta. Whatever. Then plus, I'm taking common. Now both are same, tan square theta. So 2 minus 2 becomes 0. 0 means 1. So the common is 1. Fine, is it clear? Let's check. Tan raised to 2 into tan raised to 2. So 2 plus 2, 4. Correct? Tan square theta into 1, tan square theta. That is also correct. Clear? I hope it is clear. So you check. Again cross multiply check when you have taken the proper common. Now what you will do next? What you will do? You have to convert everybody to what? Secant square, no? So all the tan square you have to convert to what? Secant square. So which formula you use? Our famous 29, formula number 29. Remember I told you 26, 29 and 32. These three formulas are very important. 26, 29, 32. 27 and 28 formula number 27 and 28, they are based on 26. Okay, clear? 30 and 31 are based on 29. 33 and 34 are based on 32. Okay, so let's see. So what is the formula? What is tan square theta? What can I write tan square theta as? See your formula. Tan square theta, what can I write tan square theta? See formula number 30. According to formula 30, tan square theta is secant square theta minus 1. So tan square theta, this is secant square theta minus 1. Is it clear? I hope this is clear. Okay. Should I put this in the bracket so that you don't get confused? Okay, let me put it in the bracket. Then, what about this guy, which I have put in the wavy sign? Here also. This tan square theta. What is tan square theta? What is tan square theta? Secant square theta minus 1. So here also, what can I write? This tan square theta also I can write secant square theta minus 1. Whatever, can you see? Tan square theta I wrote as secant square theta minus 1. Here also I wrote tan square theta secant square theta minus 1. Which formula I use, I told you? We use formula number 30. Formula number 30 we use. Okay, now you wrote this tan square theta secant square theta minus 1. But there is one here, plus 1. That you have to write separately, okay? Now what will happen? Common sense. Minus 1 and plus 1 will cancel. So what will you get? So I'll get secant square theta minus 1, bracket the same thing down, into what is left here. Minus 1 plus 1 got cancelled. So what left? Secant square theta. Now what you'll do? Cross multiply. You'll open the bracket. You'll multiply. Secant square into secant square becomes what? Secant raised to 4 theta. Yes or no? When you multiply, the indices, the powers get added, no? So 2 plus 2 becomes 4. Minus, what is secant square theta? See, first you multiply him by this fellow, no? Secant square into secant raised to 4. Then you multiply secant square with 1. Secant square theta multiplied by 1 is what? Secant square theta. And that is my right hand side. So, takes care of that. Fine? You can copy this sum now. Okay, so we now move on to the fourth sum. Problem set 6, page number 138. Question number 5, sub question 4, the proofs. Page number 138. So, now, this is a very nice, this is a very simple sum. Only understand the logic. What we have to do, you just look at the left hand side and the right hand side. And we see the logic, is there any connection? Is there any connection? Like in the previous sum, remember, left hand side we had tan square theta. In the fifth sum, tan raised to 4. No, that fifth question just now which we did before this, the fifth question problems. And then this question number 5, the sub question 5. On the left hand side we have tan square theta, and on the right hand side we have secant square theta. Barabar. So, and we all knew there is a connection. There is a formula which connected tan square theta and secant square theta. That is 1 plus tan square theta equal to secant square theta. Right. So here also. You will see the connection. Is there any connection? Yes. Is there a connection between this? So there is a connection between cot square theta and cosecant square theta. What is the formula? The formula number 32. Cot square theta and cosecant, what is their formula? The main formula, 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosecant square theta. Same way we are, just now we did in the sum number 5. Okay. There is a relation between also tan square theta and secant square theta. Which formula? Formula number 29. That is 1 plus tan square theta is secant square theta. That means there is a relation between both these two. Okay, right? Are you getting what I'm saying? So there is a relation between cot square theta and cosecant square theta. That is formula number 32. And tan square theta and secant square theta. Huh? But I will give the other two versions which is meant for that. So it goes easy. Now let's see. So I'll just underline this. And this I'll do a double underline so you don't get confused. Okay? So cot square theta. So what is cot square theta? So based on formula number 32, is formula number 33 and 34, they are based on 32. So which formula applies to cot square theta? That is formula number 33. And where is formula number 33 come from? I told you formula number 33 and 34 has come from 32. 33 and 34 formulas have come from 32. Same with 30 and, I am repeating again, 30 and 31 formulas are based on 29, formula number 29. Same way 27 and 28 number formula are based on 26. So, the main formula is 1 plus cot square theta secant square, cosecant square theta. But we will use formula number 33. What is formula number 33 says? Cot square theta is, what is cot square theta? Apparently formula number 33, cosecant square theta minus 1. So, that was formula number 33. And formula number 33 is based on 32. Remember that. So, I am just underlining this. Minus, okay. What is tan square theta? Tan square theta, where is that? Formula number 30. Where you get formula for tan square theta? In the previous, in sum number 5 also we use tan square theta. What was that formula number? Formula number 30. Formula number 30. So what is formula number 30 says? Tan square theta is equal to secant square theta minus 1. So this tan square theta is secant square theta minus 1. So tan square theta is secant square theta minus 1. But formula number 30 has actually come from where? From formula number 29. Okay, I am repeating again. So, this has come from 30. Okay, so this has come from formula 33, this has come from formula number 30. But 33 is based on 32 and 30 is based on 29. And so, 27 and 28 formula number are based on 26. Okay, remember that. Equal to. Now, what will happen? So, now there is, I will put this in bracket. So, this is one. So, I will put this bracket so that you don't get confused. And here also I'll have a bracket, whatever. So I'll now open the bracket. So I'll say cosecant square theta minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 into secant square theta, minus secant square theta. Now be careful. There's a minus outside. So minus into minus, plus. So be careful, plus. So what will happen now? Common sense. Can anything get cancelled? Yes, minus 1 and plus 1 can get cancelled. So what remains with you is? Cosecant square theta minus secant square theta, and that is your right hand side. So it is very simple. It's all about connecting. As I told you, if you know the formulas, these 34 formulas, if you know, you can easily do this whole lesson. This lesson will be very easy for you. So please study these 34 formulas. Now you must have referred to the formula in the list, you know, every now and then. For exam, you cannot carry this formula list. Then you will have to learn it on your own. So please study this formula. And then the whole lesson will be very easy for you.